Good morning children, this is the part 2 video in knowing about the plants. So in this video we will know the difference between dicot plants and monocot plants. So if you want to know more clearly about the dicot and monocot plants, we have to conduct one activity. So that is activity 2. For this activity, what do we need? So the aim, what's the aim of this experiment? To observe the cotyledons of the beans and finger millets comparatively with their roots. That means there is a relationship between the cotyledons and their root system. For this experiment, what do we need? 2 paper cups and soil and bean seeds and few finger millets. Here, instead of bean seeds, we can take black gram, green gram. So any things we can take. And instead of finger millets, we can take jowar, wheat, paddy. And what do you do? Take 2 paper cups and fill the take 2 paper cups and fill with the fertile soil. Take 2 paper cups and fill with the fertile soil. After that, sow 2 or 3 bean seeds in 1 cup and sow few finger millets in another teacup. Later, sprinkle the water. After couple of days, what we can observe? So thusly we will see the sprouts. Observe, and after few days, observe the newly emerging leaves of the sprouts. Take out the plants of the soil carefully and observe them roots. See, and this is the bean plant and these are the wheat plants. Okay, so if we observe the plants carefully, the bean plant have a 2 seed leaves, but here the wheat plants have a only 1 seed leaf. Generally, all the grains, when they are grown, whenever they sprout, they have only single leaf. But beans, like beans, black gram, green gram, so all these have a 2 seed leaves. So see, here some questions are given in your textbook. How many leaves are emerged from the bean seed? How many leaves it will come? There are 2. How many leaves emerged from the finger millet seed? There are only 1, the first of all, because it has a 1 cotyledon. It has a 2 cotyledons. So the first leaves emerging from the seed during germination are known as seed leaf. So whenever the seed, whenever the bean plant grown, they will give 2 leaves. So these 2 leaves will be called as a seed leaves. So the seed leaf with the seed is called cotyledon. What is cotyledon? The seed leaf with the seed is called cotyledon. So upon germination, these cotyledons emerge as the first leaves of a seedling. So these are the first seed leaves. Okay, so plants are called, classified as a monocots and dicots based on the number of cotyledons. See, bean has a 2 cotyledons, so it is called as a dicot plant. And finger millet, wheat, paddy, so those plants have only 1 cotyledon, so it is called as a monocot plant. Now sprinkle the water over the seedlings. Take out the plants out of the soil carefully along with their roots and observe the roots. So what kind of root system do you find the bean plant? So bean plant have a taproot system. So bean plant have a taproot system. And what kind of root system do you find in the finger millet? So finger millet have a fibrous root system. That means the leaves with have a 2 cotyledons or dicot plants have a taproot system. The plants which have a single leaf, that means they are monocots, they have a fibrous root system. So examples for monocots are paddy, wheat, grain, food grains. And examples of dicot plants are beans, groundnut, black gram, green gram. These are all dicot plants examples were. And from the above activity, we have learnt The dicot plant have a which type of root system? Taproot system. And monocot plant have a fibrous root system. So observe the plants in your surroundings and find out whether all the dicot plants have a root taproot system. Yes, all the dicot plants have a taproot system also. So water absorption by root. To observe the absorption of so what's the aim of this activity? To observe the absorption of water by root. So what do you need? A carrot, a glass of water and blue ink. So carrot is a vegetable, it is a part of your root. So that's why we took here carrot. So what to do? So place a carrot in that water, pour some water into this glass and add some blue ink to this water. Okay. So leave the carrot water for 2 or 3 days, then cut the parrot part the longitudinally, then the cut part lengthwise and observe. So then what will happen? What do you see? The blue color appears in the carrot. So inside the carrot, it will be turned into blue color. So what do you learn? The blue color indicates that water move upwards in the carrot and showing that root conducts water. Conducts means root transport the water. Because the main function of the root is it absorbs the water and minerals from the soil and it be transported to the stem. And the functions of the root fixes the plant to the soil. So absorb the water and minerals from the soil and stores food in some plants like carrot and beetroot. That means it fixes the plant. It can absorb the water and minerals from the soil and it is a modification of the root. So in these plants, the carrot and beetroot, they can store the food also. So do you know modifications of roots? That means modification means actually root function is the main function of root is fix the plant into the soil and absorb the water and minerals from the. Sometimes root modified into it performs some special functions. That is modification of roots. Some plants store food in their roots and stems. Some plants like radish, carrot, beetroot store food and food materials and their roots. So these roots bulges. That means the size of the roots will be increases and are called tubers. So can you give some more examples? Beetroot and carrot, but garlic is a stem. See, sometimes root performs on special functions also. So see, the children are playing under the banyan tree. So because banyan tree has a aerial roots. So this is a sugarcane plant. It has a lateral roots. So these roots will give additional support to the plant. And these area indicates mangroves. So mangrove plants are grown in mud areas. So in mud, there is no availability of oxygen. That's why the roots will be grown. Above the ground. So in mangrove plants, the roots are generally where the roots are present. Generally, the roots grow inside the soil, but with a lack of oxygen, these roots are grown above the ground. These roots have a small pores. With the pores, they absorb the oxygen from the atmosphere. So they can do respire. So these roots will be called as a respire roots. And these roots, lateral roots, these are aerial roots. But these roots will give support to the plants. So in order to perform some additional in functions, in some plants roots grow above the ground. Such roots are called aerial roots. They give additional support to the plants like banyan tree, sugarcane and maize, and they are also helpful in the respiration in mangroves. So in mangrove plants, aerial roots helps in respiration. In banyan tree and sugarcane, maize, they will give additional support to the plant. Okay children, thank you for watching this video. Please like my video, share my videos to your friends and subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon. Thank you.